Well, joining us on this exclusive Dundee Stars live interview, it is Ryan Valentini. Ryan, of course, announced to the Stars fans and faithful over the weekend. Ryan, I'm going to ask you my standard start-off question. How delighted are you to be a Dundee Star for this upcoming season?
Yeah, I'm very excited. I've heard a lot of good things about the city, the organization, the fans. Obviously, talking to Mark, I believe in what he's putting together with this team. I'm just excited. It's nice to kind of know where you're going in July and just be able to prepare for it for about a month and a half or so. And yeah, I'm excited. I couldn't be happier.
And how did those conversations go with Mark? I'm sure you had a few options, or more than a few, around Europe of places to go, potentially even in the Elite League. What was it that Mark Lefebvre said that convinced you this is the place that you want to be next season?
I think the first thing, just as a player, his belief in me. I think he's watched clips of me or talked to coaches, and I think our team needed a player like that can play my game, my style, and I think Mark believes in my style and my game, and it was nice to, you know, it's nice to hear that when a coach says those things. And I guess the other thing is just he wants to win, and he wants to put together a winning team. I know last year didn't go, I guess, the way everyone wanted it to, and it's kind of a fresh start for the organization, and that's kind of what I'm excited about, is being part of that, a bit of a culture change, a bit of a revamping, if you will, and I'm just excited to be a part of that, be part of a winning team.
How much does that mean, or how important is that when you get a coach calling up? Because obviously it's a small network around in hockey in Europe, but to have them calling, they've watched your tapes and they know exactly where you would fit into the side that they're putting together.
Yeah, it's a nice feeling, right? He said all the right things in terms of how he sees my game and how he sees where I can fit in the team, right? And I think I've always believed in myself, but to have kind of someone who, just based on video and speaking to people, like I said, who seems to believe in my abilities as well, it's a nice feeling, and it's a big part of why I made my decision.
And you mentioned, of course, last season the Stars not finishing in the positions that they wanted to. The season before that, finishing seventh in the league, which qualified them for the playoffs, and then they ended up going to the final four series. As a player who perhaps doesn't know the club, but just how much does that play into it when you're looking at where a team finished the season before? Or is it how they're forward thinking and what they're looking at now when you're making those decisions?
Yeah, I think what you just said at the end there is exactly what it is. It's you don't really worry too much about how they've done in the past. It's more about what this upcoming year is going to be all about, and kind of the vision of the coach, the vision of the team. Like I said, it seems like everyone's kind of hungry to get back to the top or around the top and make the playoffs and have a push for you know, the championship. And like I said, I'm excited to be a part of kind of like a rebuild and be a big part of what should hopefully be a successful season.
You talk about your game and your game fitting into these plans that Mark has spoken to you about. Just what is your game for the Stars fans? I know they've watched the highlight clips, but what is your game? What are you going to bring to their lineup this year that they're going to watch?
I'm a creative player. I have a lot of skill, or at least I've been told. I'm a creative player. I like to make my teammates better. I like to hold on to the puck, make plays. I'm probably more of an offensive player. With that being said, I think I have a better two-way game than I think. Obviously, in the highlight video, you're not really seeing defensive plays. It's more of the offensive stuff. But like I said, I'm a skilled player. I like to have the puck on my stick a lot. I like to make plays. I enjoy the game. I play the game with some enthusiasm. I like to feed off the energy of the crowd.
And that sounds exciting, and that's what the fans will be looking forward to. Just could you talk us through, of course, you've been in Europe already. I think the 2020-21 season was your first season, and that experience. What was that experience like then, taking that first step into Europe away from Canada?
Yeah, it was a bit weird, to be honest with you. I came over right during the pandemic, kind of in the thick of it. I was playing university hockey in Canada, and they kind of shut down our season. And I knew missing an entire year wasn't what I wanted to do, having missed previous seasons due to injuries and stuff like that. So I knew I wanted to play that season, and it seemed like the right fit. And it was a fun year. It was a good experience. It was just a bit, like I said, it was a bit odd, just no fans in some of the rinks. We weren't able to do too much outside of the rink with COVID. So it was kind of a hockey dominant heavy year, as opposed to more of a well-rounded season with things outside of the rink. So it had its quirks for sure with COVID, but I enjoyed it, and I've enjoyed playing in Europe since as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And we can get into that a little bit afterwards. Just how much did that year prepare you? I think the season after that, you went to the East Coast League, started off at Rapid City Rush, which Dundee Stars fans are familiar with some of their ex-players being there. But, you know, 21 games, I think 23 points was your tally there at Rapid City. Just how much did that season, that first season in Europe, I think when you got 32 points, prepare you for that move back into the East Coast League?
Yeah, like I said, it was a bit of a weird year, and coming off that year, it was a bit. I think the aftermath, to put it, lack of a better word, just of COVID, kind of made it finding a job back overseas a bit weird. And I knew I wanted to play in North America at some point, and the opportunity came up, and it was a bit of a weird year playing for a couple different teams, but that's kind of what you prepare yourself for in the East Coast. And I had some success, and I think that year in the East Coast Hockey League was big for my career, and kind of proved that I can play and put up some points and kind of be a contributing offensive player regardless of what the opportunity I'm given is.
Yeah, you mentioned that difficulty in that league. Of course, I think you were at a good number of teams that season, and it is something that happens quite regularly there for players. Just how difficult was that switching around like that, or did you just see it always as a moment to prove yourself again?
Yeah, I think you just hit the nail on the head. I always kind of have that mindset. I'm just going to go in and play my game. And these teams, they trade for you for a reason, right? They need your style of player. It's kind of an ever-changing league. There's always guys going up, going down. So it was about the fit. And I think being traded was a bit weird, having to, like, you know, drive across the country and whatnot. But I just like playing hockey, man. I can't emphasize that enough. I like being a part of, you know, winning games, and it was just an opportunity for me to go prove myself somewhere else. And I think I learned from it. I learned a lot from that season, and I think it's led me to where I am today.
It certainly has. You mentioned, of course, that first opportunity in Europe preparing you, and something you enjoyed and wanted to do again. So you did that last season, started off in Slovakia. What was that league like, and what was your experience like there?
Yeah, it was a good league. A lot better than I think people give it credit for. I think there's a lot of good Slovakian players. A lot of good local players are actually very, very talented hockey players. Some older players who have a lot of experience, and then some younger guys who've got the, you know, the work ethic, and they all want to get better. I think that's something that I learned in that league, was guys, different ways you can take care of yourself and different ways you can kind of prepare for games. I think I played with a few Russian guys, a few Latvian guys. So it was different in the sense that it was a kind of a mixed bag of players and personalities. It was a cool experience. I mean, that team was, yeah, it was, we were a good team, and it just didn't work out the way I had planned when I went over there, and we ended up moving on. But it was a good experience. I definitely learned a lot from that, and I try to take the positives out of every situation.
Yeah, and a little bit of time in the DEL after that as well, DEL2. What was that experience like?
Yeah, I mean, I can't say enough good things about Hellbron and the guys we had there. Some older players who were kind of at the tail end of their careers, whether they were Canadians or, you know, German Canadians with German passports and stuff like that. It was cool. Cool town. Unfortunately, the team was relegated, but It was a good experience. I think the DL2 is a really good league, and there's a lot of really good players who spend time there, and they want to stay just because the way they're treated and the way the league is run is pretty top class.
And of course, we've mentioned already, everyone's aware, but you're going to be part of the Elite League this year, part of the Dundee Stars organisation. Just what did you know about the Elite League in your research and in your conversations? And do you know any other players who currently play in the league or previously played that have passed on that experience and information to you that helped you make the choice?
Yeah, I mean, you look around the league, there's quite a few North American players, quite a few players who I would have played against, whether it's at school, in junior hockey, or even in the East Coast League. So it's definitely always been a league that I knew that I would, if the right opportunity came around, I would definitely want to be a part of. Like I said, there's a lot of North American players. I think the language, there's no language barrier, which is nice. And it's from what I heard, it's a growing league that, you know, keeps getting better, and I'm excited to be a part of it. Excited for a new opportunity to prove myself.
Yeah, it's definitely a league that's progressed every year. It's improved in quality every year. A host of games, a large number of games, and a lot of travel around the season. But does that excite you as a hockey player to play a lot of games, be involved in the action, and have those pressures?
Yeah, for sure. Like I said earlier, I just love playing hockey. I love being on the ice. And that's one thing I think I liked about the East Coast Hockey League was we played a lot of games in a week, and kind of not as much downtime in terms of practicing and stuff. You're kind of right in the mix all the time, playing games, traveling and whatnot. So I enjoyed it over there, and I'm sure I'll enjoy it in the EIHL. So I'm excited to play a lot of hockey games. I think the last few years I haven't really played as many games as I would have liked to, just with different circumstances. So it'll be exciting to play like a full season, lots of games, and, you know, continue to get better as a player and you know, contribute to a winning team.
That's it. Talking of winning, some huge games, none other than games against Blasco Clan, against the Fife Flyers, which are the local rival teams. Are those the games that you look forward to as a hockey player, playing in the high pressure, high intense games with that atmosphere?
Yeah, for sure. Like I said, I tend to feed off the crowd. I'm not the most I don't know the word for it, but I'm not the most flashy player, loudest guy on the ice. But I think when the crowd gets going, and you know, you score a big goal, or you're part of a, you know, a big win, whether it's against a rival or just another home game, I love to see the fans in the crowd get excited, and it makes me want to bring my game to another level. And I've heard good things about the rivalries. I've heard good things about the fans, like I said, and I'm excited to, you know, feed off that energy and be in that environment.
You sure will get that energy. Those games are packed out, usually 2,000 people in our arena, and some bigger crowds in other arenas as well. So certainly, as a player, do you like being the guy that goes to, say, the arena that's full, actually? So like a Sheffield arena, say, that's got, you know, 5,000 people there, and being with that team that's able to score the goal and silence them? Or is it much more fun being the player who's playing in front of the home crowd and scoring?
I guess they both have their, you know, their quirks and their positives. It's definitely fun to score goals on the road and kind of quiet the crowd, if you will. Listen, you just hear the bench, the only people excited about a goal. It's kind of an interesting, fun experience. Like I said, the energy, whether it's positive or negative, I kind of feed off it. Obviously, I think the home crowd will be better. More support is always better. But like I said, I like to feed off the crowd. I like to, you know, look into the stands and see the people into the game. It kind of gets me a bit more into it and gets me excited to, you know, like I said, be a part of a winning team.
We can't wait to see you silence crowds in our counterparts arenas, and we can't wait to see you make loads of noise. In terms of your own game, Ryan, where do you want to develop it this year? Where do you think Mark's going to be able to improve it as a coach? What are you thinking?
I think as an offensive player, I think there's always an emphasis on, you know, getting better in your own end and becoming a better two-way player. And like I said, I think that's something that I think it's a little bit underrated about my game. It's something that I've really focused on the last few seasons as a pro, kind of developing. And I know that the value a two-way center has in professional hockey. So I think I have the tools offensively and as well as defensively to, you know, be that two-way player. I think that's something that I've been striving towards for the last, like I said, few years now, dating back to junior hockey, just focusing on that as well as developing my offensive game. So I think that's probably the main thing that I'd say I'm looking to develop this year, continue to grow with it.
And we noticed that it's your birthday in a couple of days, actually.
Yeah.
What is the plan? You got any celebration plans on the go?
I'm not sure. I'm not a big birthday guy, to be honest with you. I think I got a lot of celebrating done when I was a little kid in the backyard with all my buddies and stuff. I'll probably head up north to the cottage with some friends this weekend. But like I said, I'm not a big birthday guy. I'm not going to throw myself a big party. If my girlfriend wants to go up to dinner, I'm sure we'll do that. But yeah, it's a weird thing with birthdays. I think, like I said, I got the celebrating done when I was younger. That's just another year now. If anything, I kind of dread it getting older, but it is what it is, and it'll be a fun week regardless.
Come on, Ryan, positivity. Yeah. But I hope there's going to be better celebrations when you win, say, the Challenge Cup with the Dundee Stars, or take us to the playoff weekend, you know, and score that winning goal.
Yeah, no, for sure. Like I said, those are the things that excite me. My birthday might not excite me as much as it used to, but you know, like I said, winning games and being a part of a winning team, I was able to experience that in university at Guelph, and it was some of the best times of my life. And that's kind of what I made it a priority when I signed here, that I thought we would be putting together a winning team and kind of making a culture that's gonna, you know, last and be successful. And like I said, that's my favorite part. Probably the thing that motivates me most is, you know, being a part of a winning team. And I'm looking forward to it. I really am.
Well, have you got a final message for the Stars fans before we sign off on this one?
I appreciate the support so far. I mean, it's been a warm welcome. I'm reading some of the posts and stuff. Gotten some messages. I appreciate it. I'm looking forward to meeting you all. I'm looking forward to playing in front of you, and hope I can be a good representative of the team.
Well, we hope so as well, Ryan. We're delighted to have you and excited to see you here on the ice in September. Some great friendly fixtures are, well, not friendly fixtures. There's no friendly games, is there? But, you know, some good exhibition games coming up before the season starts as well against opposition from Europe. So very exciting times as well. But just to remind everyone, you can join Ryan and everyone else at the Dundee Stars and commit to buying a season ticket for the season. It would be very much appreciated. I'm sure Ryan and the rest of the guys would love to see you there week in, week out. And you could get more information about that by visiting dundeestars.com. That's dundeestars.com, or all of our social media pages will have information as well on how you could do that. Ryan, have a great birthday when it comes. I know you're not a celebrator, but I'm sure you'll find something to do. And hey, we'll see you in, it's literally a few short weeks, 6 weeks or so.
Yeah. You'll be right on. I'm excited. Thanks for having me.